Hey, I'm James Blunt, and I'm here to offer up some good old English advice here on Vevo. Dear James, I've been in a fulfilling relationship for the past 7 years, but our bedroom activities have become a little stale. I want to suggest a threesome with another woman, but I'm unsure how to broach this topic. Miss 1 plus 2 equals orgasm. Is that my wife? Is that my wife? I hope that's my wife. I really hope. Dear James, my girlfriend and I love to go dancing, but every time we go to the club, I wind up feeling like a stripper's pole instead of her dance partner. How can I tell her to ease up on the bump and grind? Mr. Don't Ride It, My Pony. You're complaining about your girlfriend treating you like a stripper's pole. What the fuck is wrong with you? Mr. Don't Ride It, My Pony. You are a lucky, lucky man and a douche for complaining. Shut up. Dear James, I recently had a case of word vomit and told the girl I'm dating I can play the guitar. I don't actually know the guitar. Now I'm paranoid she'll want me to play something for her. If you could recommend one song I should focus on learning, it'd be greatly appreciated. Mr. Struggling to Serenade. Yeah, I mean, it's trouble I've had throughout my career is that people think I can play the guitar too, but all you need is four chords and one song. And you know that song. Dear James, my boyfriend thinks he's going to be the next Ed Sheeran. He's determined to apply for The Voice. The problem is his falsetto sounds like a couple of mating foxes. Help, Ms. Earplugs, at all times. What's wrong with aspiring to be the next James Blunt? Why does it have to be fucking Ed Sheeran? Dear James, I'm totally addicted to using dating apps. I started off with me looking for love, and now I'm driven by the thrill of fresh flesh rather than the desire to make a meaningful connection. How do I kick this app life? Mr. Swipe Right. I actually genuinely feel quite sad because I missed Tinder. It's something that I never got a chance to use. So enjoy it while you can and email me and tell me how it's going. Dear James, I'm the editor of a popular music blog and make a living from people thinking my taste is exemplary. But honestly, I think Migos suck and I would rather dance around in my apartment in my underwear to Shawn Mendes. Should I continue to deceive my readership to make a buck? Mr. Living a Lie. If you have terrible music taste, then I really want to get in touch with you because I have a new album out and you should check it out. It's called The Afterlove. It's in the post. Dear James, lately I've had a strong desire to buy a motorcycle. My girlfriend is begging me not to because her father was in a bad motorcycle accident years ago. I understand her concerns, but I truly want this bike. What do you think I should do? Mr. Harley or Love? It's an interesting one. I mean, your life expectancy on a motorcycle is 36 times worse off than people who drive cars, so you are more likely to die. I totally get the problem. I'm a smaller man. I've owned a motorcycle all my life to try and impress the opposite sex. This is why I took up the guitar and do music, and why I became a soldier for the uniform. And I think you should get it. And all I would say is, you know, standard practice. Wear protection, lube up, and you'll be fine. Dear James, I took a pill in Ibiza to show Avicii I was cool. It didn't work. Mayday, how do I stay relevant? Mr. Likely lost my edge years ago. My Posner, I'm sorry man, I just gave you a bad pill. Come back and I'll give you a better time.